Former National Security Advisor Roilo Golez is in the studio with us to expound on his insights. Secretary Golez, thank you for joining us again on The Big Story.
Yeah, thank you so much.
So even the very premise for this supposed research that is for scientific purposes is immaterial to you.
Well, it's why China? You know, if it's scientific research on a big piece of national wealth, Benham Rice, why them? Considering their history in grabbing and even claiming 90% of the West Philippine Sea, they occupied, they seized Mischief Reef, assured us that it is only for temporary shelter for the fishermen. Now it's a huge structure inside our exclusive economic zone. They're blockading us from exploring wreck to bank. Reportedly very rich in natural gas and maybe oil. They grabbed Scarborough Shoal in 2012. Now we are giving them an opening into Benham Rice. Why them? If it's scientific, there are many other countries that are neutral, that have no claim against our territory.
Yes, government has said that for them, good faith at this point in our relationship simply means No additional island building, no additional territories. But that's granting that they have encroached already on certain territories. How should we define good faith? And for that matter, bad faith?
Well, good faith would be what's their record in their past assurances, whether they made good their assurance. And if you ask me, they have not. They've not made good. And now we are again opening the door to Benham Rice. Well, I call it territory because we have sovereign rights for the exploitation and exploration of natural resources, living and non-living. Mm. Now, I'm a little worried. You know, when I saw the terms of reference of the scientific survey, what was mentioned there is that they'd like to conduct a temperature study of Benham Rice. That's very alarming. You know, in the Navy, in submarine warfare, you take the temperature, not only in the sea surface, but at the bottom. That means that they're going to chart and map the area for thermocline. Right. Thermocline is that area where if a destroyer, for example, is looking for a submarine, its sonar pulses would be reflected. It would not penetrate the thermocline. So a submarine can hide under. Benham Rice protrudes into the Western Pacific. China has been wanting to get into the Western Pacific, which right now is dominated by the US Navy and also by Japan. And they'd like to have an entry point into the Western Pacific. And to me, I'm worried that this is the geostrategic agenda, because this is quite a big area where a lot of submarines can hide, you know, 13 million hectares. That's
supposedly,
quite a big area.
Supposedly.
And if they succeed in doing that, they'll be able to project their power into the Western Pacific. Even if you place a battalion of Philippine representatives there, there's no way that they can find out what is exactly being gathered. There's no way that the observers will find out what would be going into the computer. And if ever they would share the data to the Philippines, we would never know whether this is complete data or altered data or data that would be useful to us, but only useful to them. You know, we have to be very cautious in dealing with national security. And here, it's not only national security, food security. I'm also concerned that they might be eyeing Benham Rice as a source of food. It's very rich in fish. And China right now is hungry for food. In fact, they go all the way to West Africa, to South America in order to fish. Marine biology experts are saying that they practically drained the South China Sea, especially with the destruction of about 3,000 acres of corals inside the South China Sea. And here they are. You know, they have deployed about 2,600 ocean-going fishing boats for fishing.
Yes.
Now, the other worry I have is on energy. Again, Benham Rice is reportedly very rich in energy. natural gas and methane hydrates. The Constitution is very clear. We must protect our marine wealth in our territorial sea, archipelagic waters, and also our exclusive economic zone.
Yes, all of these interests, military, energy, oil, and then, of course, also fisheries. But the government says that in all of these things, one of the guiding values for them is the livelihood of our fishers, particularly of Zambales. And they said, look, we know that there's controversy around our decisions, but look, at least our fishermen are able to fish at peace. What do you say to government when they say that this is the thing that's actually guided our decisions on how we deal with China?
Well, I congratulate the government. In fact, I'm very happy with the way they've handled the diplomacy. But remember, our fishermen were free to fish there before, for a century, maybe longer than that, before they grabbed the Scarborough Shoal without any legal basis at all. And then after that, after grabbing it, then they let it go a little bit and give it our fishermen. We should not thank them because that's ours. In fact, Republic Act 9522 is very clear. Scarborough Shoal is within our jurisdiction and sovereignty.
Now, in the days ahead, again, another thing that government says is, look, at least they asked for our permission. That does something. But we've granted permission. What does this do at the end of the day in the balance of what both China and the Philippines are trying to put forward in the international community and in terms of laying claim to these territories?
Well, China, admittedly, is very good at science, you know, marine science. We have to grant it to them. But as I said, I'm just a little bit worried about the geostrategic agenda. Let's go neutral, anyone but China in this particular case. If we really want to make it purely scientific, no hidden agenda, anyone but China, ABC.
Okay, Mr. Golez, thank you for joining us in The Big Story.
Thank you, Robbie.